Welcome to the lecture on Smitriga. In this lecture, we are going to see the Smitriga circuit diagram, working input and output waveforms, and the applications. Smitriga. Smitriga is a wave shaping circuit used for the generation of square waveform from a sinusoidal waveform or non-sinusoidal waveforms. It is a bistable circuit in which two transistor switches are connected regeneratively. This is the circuit diagram of Smitriga, where it consists of two identical transistors Q1 and Q2 coupled through an emitter resistance RE. The resistance R1 and R2 form a voltage divider bias across VC1 and ground. This provides a small forward bias to the base emitter junction of the transistor Q2. So now let us see the condition of the transistors Q1 and Q2 when there is no input is given. Before that, let us see some basics regarding this. So here we are going to use the transistor Q1 and Q2 as switches. So when a transistor is on, its collector voltage will be equal to VCE plus VRE. And when a transistor is off, its collector voltage will be equal to VCC. And VBE equal to VB minus VE. So when there is no input signal and when only the DC supply is switched on, because of this voltage divider formed by R1 and R2, the transistor Q2 turns on. As the transistor Q2 is turned on, the current through the resistance RE increases, which in turn develops a voltage drop across this resistance RE. So as the current IE increases, the cut-in voltage of the transistor Q1 decreases, which makes the transistor Q1 off. So at this instant, the collector voltage of Q1 will be VCC and the collector voltage of Q2 will be VCE sat plus VRE, as the transistor Q2 is in the on condition. So now let us assume that an input voltage is applied to this circuit, and let us see how the transistors Q1 and Q2 converts this sinusoidal input into a square waveform. When the input voltage increases above zero, nothing will happen till it crosses the upper trigger level. Upper trigger level means when the input voltage Vin is greater than VBE1 plus VRE. As the input voltage increases above this level UTL, the transistor Q1 is on. The point at which Q1 starts conducting is known as upper trigger point. As the transistor Q1 is on, the collector voltage VC1 decreases, which in turn decreases the cut-in voltage of the transistor Q2. This reduces the current through the resistance RE, and hence VRE gets reduced. So as the VRE gets reduced, the transistor Q2 goes into the off condition. This process continues till QR is driven into saturation and the transistor Q2 is cut off. At this instant, the collector voltage of Q1 will be equal to VCE sat plus VRE, and the collector voltage of the transistor Q2 is VCC. So we are taking the output at the collector of Q2, hence this conversion is obtained. Since the transistor Q2 is off at this instant, its collector voltage is equal to VCC, hence we obtain this conversion. Transistor Q1 will continue to conduct till the input voltage crosses the lower trigger level. So, lower trigger level is when Vin is lesser than or equal to VBE1 plus VRE. Because of this, the transistor Q1 will be in off condition and the collector voltage starts decreasing. And the collector voltage increases towards the VCC. The point at which Q2 starts conducting is called the lower trigger point. That is, when the transistor Q1 is off, the VC1 increases, which in turn increases the cut-in voltage of the transistor Q2, and hence it will turn on. So, this happens when the Vin is lesser than or equal to VBE1 plus VRE. And this point, that is the instant at which Q2 turns on, is known as the lower trigger point. Then Q2 is driven into saturation and Q1 is driven into cutoff, and at this instant the collector voltage of Q1 will be VCC and the collector voltage of Q2 will be VCE sat plus VRE, because the transistor Q2 is now in the on condition and its collector voltage will be at this level. Hence, we obtain the conversion this point. And these are the input and the output waveforms of the Schmitt trigger. And the upper one is the input waveform. The lower one is the converted waveform. That is the output of the Schmitt trigger. So, if we note here, if the input voltage is lesser than the upper threshold point. So, here you have to remember that there are two levels. One is the lower trigger level, other one is the upper trigger level. And this point is called the upper threshold point and this point is called the lower threshold point. So, when the input voltage is lesser than the upper threshold point, the transistor Q1 will be in the off condition and Q2 will be on. So, hence Q2, that is the output voltage, will be equal to VCE plus VRE. And this process continues until the input voltage reaches the level UTP. Once the level UTP, that is when the input voltage reaches UTP, the transistor Q1 turns on and transistor Q2 is off. And Q2 output voltage will be equal to VCC. So, hence we obtain this level. And this conversion takes place until the input voltage reaches the lower threshold point. So, when the input reaches the lower threshold point, the transistor Q1 is off and transistor Q2 is on. And the output voltage is equal to VCS at plus VRE again. And hence we obtain this conversion, and this conversion occurs up to, once again, the UTP is attained. So, this process continues again and again, and hence a non-sinusoidal waveform is converted into a square waveform by the Schmitt trigger circuit. Hysteresis of Schmitt trigger. So, this is the hysteresis of Schmitt trigger. The difference between UTP and LTP is known as hysteresis voltage VH. VH is also known as the dead zone of the Schmitt trigger. The lagging of the lower threshold voltage from the upper threshold voltage is known as hysteresis. That is, and this loop is called the hysteresis loop. Applications of Schmitt trigger. Schmitt trigger is used for wave shaping circuit. and it is used for the generation of rectangular waveform from a sine waveform or any other waveform. So in this lecture we have seen the conversion of a sine waveform into a rectangular waveform, but a Schmidt trigger is capable of converting any non-sinusoidal waveform into the rectangular waveform, and hence we can say the Schmidt trigger is used for wave shaping circuits, or in other case we can say it is used for the generation of the square or rectangular waveform, which depends on the input. And it is used as a voltage comparator by making use of the points upper threshold point and the lower threshold point. We can say it can be used as a voltage comparator also. Hysteresis in Schmidt trigger is valuable when conditioning noisy signals for using digital circuits. The noise does not cause false triggering, and so the output will be free from noise. Thank you for listening to this lecture.